Good morning, students. Today's class we will see about the Consumer Protection Act in Healthcare in India. Consumer Protection Act in Healthcare Services in India. A consumer is a person who hires or avails of any service for a consideration and includes any beneficiary of such service other than the person who hires or avails of the service. When such service are availed of with approval of the first mentioned person. Maybe it may be a little difficult definition for you to understand. This one will be clear. A consumer is one who is decision maker whether or not to buy an item at the store or someone who is influenced by an advertisement and marketing. Any individual who purchases the products or services for his personal use and not for manufacturing or resale is called a consumer. Every time someone goes to a store and buys a shirt, toy, beverage or anything else, they make a decision as a consumer. A consumer refers to any person who purchases some goods for a consideration that has been either paid or promised to pay or partially paid. Consumerism. Consumerism is a social as well as an economic order which encourages the buying of goods and services in ever greater amounts. Right to information. Right to information is defined as right to be informed about the quality, quantity, potency, purity, standard and price of goods or service. As the case may be, the so as to protect the consumer against unfair trade practice in Consumer Protection Act of 1986. Rights or safety. According to Consumer Protection Act, the consumer right is referred as the right to be protected against marketing of goods and service which are hazardous to life and property. It is applicable to specific areas like healthcare and pharmaceuticals. Consumer Protection Act of 1986. Consumer Protection Act 1986 is an Act of Parliament of India enacted in 1986 to protect interest of consumers in India. Consumer Protection Act, in short we call it a CPA, aims to protect the interest of patients in case of any unethical treatment rendered by a medical or a dental health professional. With increasing commercialization of all spheres of life, all professions have come under the public scrutiny. Earlier, the role and service provided by the medical professional was considered noble and charitable. But today, with increase in medical negligence and malpractice, this profession is looked down upon with doubt and contempt. Deterioration in the standard of patient care is considered to be the due interest in the monetary gains. The Consumer Protection Act was passed on 24th December 1986 for better protection of the interest of consumers and to make provisions for the establishment of consumer councils and other authorities for the settlement of consumers' dispute and for matters connected therewith. Till 1995, even the courts were not clear whether the doctors are covered under Consumer Protection Act number. In a landmark in the case of 1995, the Supreme Court decision in Medical Association of India versus V.P. Shantapai, medical profession has been brought under the Section 210 of the Consumer Protection Act 1986, and also it has included the following categories or doctors or hospitals under this section. First one, all medical or dental practitioners doing independent or medical or dental practice unless rendering only free service. Private hospitals charging all patients. All hospitals having free as well as paying patients and all paying and free category patients receiving treatment in such hospital. Medical or dental practitioners and the hospital paid by any insurance firm for the treatment of a client or employment for that employee. The maximum time limit for a claim to be filed under CPA is 2 years from the date of occurrence of the course of action, and there is no court fees to be paid to file a complaint in a consumer forum or a commission. Further, a complaint opposite party can present his case on his own without the help of a lawyer. The court has greater responsibility to punish the guilty doctors and at the same time to protect the honest doctors from undue harassment at the hands of the patient. It makes provisions for the establishment of consumer councils and other authorities for settlement of consumers' disputes and matters connected therewith. Consumer protection councils are established at the national, state and district level to increase consumer awareness. Government may establish more than one district forum in a district. It is a district level court that deals with a case valuing up to 2 million. State Consumer Dispute Redressal Commission, also known as State Commission, established by state government in the state. It is a state level court that takes up to valuing less than 10 million. National Consumer Disputes, established by central government. It is a national level court that works for the whole country and deals the amount more than 10 million. Objectives of central council include right to be protected against the marketing of goods and services which are hazardous to life and property. The right to be informed about the quality, quantity, potency, purity, standard and price of goods or service as in the case may is to protect the consumer against unfair trade practice. The right to be assured, wherever possible, access to a variety of goods and service at the competitive prices. The right to be heard and to be assured that consumers' interest will be received due consideration at appropriate forums. The right to seek redressal against unfair trade practice or restrictive trade practice or unscrupulous exploitation of consumers, and right to consumer education. The right to against consumer exploitation. The objective of state council shall to promote the protect within the state the rights of a consumer paid down in clause 1 to 7 in central council objectives. Know your consumer's rights. The consumer's rights are: first one, the right to protect from all kind of hazardous goods and service. The right to fully informed about the performance and quality of all goods and service. The right to be free choice of goods and service. The right to be heard in all decision-making process related to the consumer's interest. The right to seek redressal whenever consumer rights have been infringed. The right to complete consumer education. If there is an infringement of rights of consumer, then complaint can be made under following circumstances reported to the clause by designated consumer court. That include the goods or service purchased by a person or agreed to be purchased by a person has one or more defects or deficiencies in any respect. Then the trader or a service provider resort unfair or restrictive practice of trade. A trader or service provider, if charges a price more than the price displayed on the goods or price that they agreed upon between the parties or the price that is stipulated under any law that exists. The consumer rights include right to safety, right to information, right to choose, right to heard, right to redress, right to consumer education, right to a healthy environment, and right to basic needs. Consumer protection in healthcare. Can you trust your doctor? Negligence is the conduct that falls below standard of care. The standard of care is established by law for the protection of consumers against unreasonable practice which create risk or harm. Nursing Practice Act describes that define the legal boundaries of nursing practice within each state. The INC and the State Nursing Council and the universities regulate the standard of practice. Sources of negligence in nursing include medication errors, intravenous therapy errors, burn to the client caused by an equipment, falls resulting in injury of the client, failure to use aseptic technique when required, errors in sponge, instruments, needles, etc. Fail to give report or giving an incomplete report, fail to monitor the client's condition, failure to notify physician a significant change in the client's condition. With advancement in nursing and expanded role of nurses, the nurses are in a position to take independent decision. This increases their responsibility and commitment. Nurses have to abide with the laws related to informed consent for operation, invasive procedures, correct identity, correct medication and drugs, medico-legal records, accuracy in documentation, not to cross the line if some errors has been occurred, care of valuables and money, death and dying issue, birth and death registry certificate. Roles and responsibilities of a nurse include: nurse should not indulge in malpractice, refuse medical practitioner indulging in malpractice, organize health education programs for public and nurses regarding Consumer Protection Act. Prevention of error. Several suggestions has been made for reducing the error. The first one, reduce reliance on memory by using checklists, protocols and computerized decisions aids for prescription writing. Improved information access with availability of computerized medical record at bedside. Error proofing. use of forcing function in a computer program so that a physician cannot enter a overdose or prescribe a medication to which the patient is allergic, standardization of drug doses and time of administration of information displays, equipment and supplies of location in the hospital, training of doctors, nursing and other staff in for the safe practice. For the individual nurses, following those strategies appear. First, read the prescription carefully. Physician prescription are at the times illegible and lead to litigation and medical errors. Medication errors occurs due to mistakes, that is knowledge based or rule based, and slips of action and lapse of memory. Focus on task at hand. Knowledgeable and experienced nurses can easily identify the mistake. Be careful while administering the drugs or doses. Doctors should avoid trailing zeros, example 10.0 mg, which may read as 100 milligram. Beware of high-risk situations like elderly patients on multiple drugs. Review basic drug related information from approved standard textbook. Avoid use of drug or unapproved, unlabeled indications, especially where the risk of drug use is higher than expected benefits. Communicate effectively when patients have family, pharmacist, a question and prescriptions. Thank you. Thank you for listening.